Welcome to the last of three short videos introducing you to development with Visual LANSA. LANSA's single skill set allows you to build applications for desktop, web, and mobile without needing to know any of the underlying technologies. In part one, I built a simple inquiry application with a header, list, and detailer. In part two, I modified the list to include sorting and a thumbnail image for each employee. And I modified the detailer to show the employee image and allow selection of a new one. Finally, I allowed a record to be saved showing LANSA's repository business rules protecting the database. Over the next few minutes, I'll modify the application layout so that it's appropriate for smaller devices such as a tablet. And after that, I'll add a third configuration allowing the application to execute on a mobile device. I'll start by adding two designs to the application, one for mobile and one for tablet. There are, of course, many different devices and many different size screens to cater for. So for simplicity in this example, I'll use two sizes of 600 and 1000 pixels. I'll then add a simple block of code to handle the change of designs at runtime. When the page is resized and a design is activated, I'll tell the application, allowing all of the individual parts to react to the change. So the first part I'll change is the detailer. The two-column design is okay for a large screen, however for smaller devices, a single column of data would be more appropriate. So I'll create a second layout. At runtime, this will be applied and all of the controls will reposition automatically. You've already seen LANSA's point-and-click WYSIWYG designer in previous videos, so once more I'll fade to black and we'll see the final result. The subheadings and fields now flow down the page, and a scroll bar has been automatically added. All I need do now is add a simple if-else routine to the code. This will apply whichever layout is appropriate. When there's a change of design, if it's the desktop, I'll use the first layout. Otherwise, I'll use the second. It's also worthy of note here that changing layout is not just a runtime feature. With just a point and a click, the designer will show me whichever layout I want to see. So with my first set of changes complete, let's see it at runtime. As the page width decreases, the single column layout is applied, and when it gets wider, it reverts to two columns. I'll now move on to the list of employees. A column-based design may be appropriate for larger screens, but for smaller devices, we need something more touch-friendly. So I'll add a column to the list, and this will be used at runtime in place of the other four columns. I could populate this column by returning the formatted data from the server. However, it's far simpler to do the processing on the client. When the server routine completes, I'll process the contents of the list, concatenating the name fields. All that's left for the list is to respond to a change of design. And as before, I'll use some simple if-else code to show or hide the columns as required. And here's the result at runtime. As the page width decreases, the columns are hidden and they're replaced by a simple scrollable list. And that's all that's required to make this application usable on a tablet, so I'll move on to mobile. As before, I'll create a second layout. Rather than the list and detailer being side by side, they will occupy the same space, switching between the two at runtime. As ever, I'll fade to black, and you'll be able to see the two parts occupy the same space. So that's the mobile layout defined. All I'd need now is my familiar if-else code. Now when I execute the application, you'll see the desktop size, the tablet, and then finally mobile. And that means I have one thing left to do. I just need some simple code to switch between the list and the detailer. Whenever the application is opening or creating an employee, I'll use one of LANSA's built-in animations to show the editor. And of course, when closing, I'll do the reverse. And so, with one final execution, we can see how the application appears on a small screen or mobile device. And that brings me to the end of this introduction to development with LANSA.